A developing story tonight. Federal authorities are offering a $100,000 reward for the person who killed a Border Patrol agent. The agent was looking for illegal smugglers in a remote area near El Campo. Antonio Castellon just arrived back from El Centro, from where the agent lived. Antonio?
Jim, the city of El Centro is in shock. People can't believe 30-year-old Border Patrol agent Robert Rosas died in the line of duty. Everyone described the husband and father of two children, a very nice, down-to-earth man. Border Patrol agents say 30-year-old Robert Rosas Jr. died of a gunshot wound to the head. The three-year veteran was tracking down illegal smugglers in a remote area of El Campo. About 9 o'clock Thursday night, Rosas was alone when he was the target of gunfire.
They went, attempted to contact the agent on the radio with no luck. They responded to the area where they knew he was going, and subsequently found our Border Patrol agent with multiple gunshot wounds.
Federal sources close to the case tell San Diego 6 that Rosa's gun and badge were stolen. The FBI says it's unknown how many people were involved in the shooting and what prompted the attack, but they believe one of the attackers was also hit and injured. Agents are checking all hospitals for patients coming in with gunshot wounds.
We do believe that it was a wound significant enough to cause blood and cause the person to bleed.
Back in El Centro, friends remember a great man.
I'm devastated right now.
Wenceslao Partida is a Border Patrol agent in the Calexico area. He knew Rosas.
I think he was a pretty good agent. You know, my prayers go to his family.
Victor Villa, a close friend, worked out with Rosas occasionally.
He was a nice guy. Every time he needed any help doing anything, hey, you know, Vic, I'm here if you need any help.
Rosas leaves behind a wife, 2-year-old son, and 11-month-old daughter. Antonio Castellan, San Diego 6 News.
And tonight, authorities are trying to determine if three people arrested in San Jose are connected at all to the shooting of Agent Rosas. Officials with the Department of Homeland Security showed up at O'Connor Hospital late this afternoon to arrest two men and one woman. As Antonio mentioned, investigators have been checking medical facilities for the suspects. Cell phone records reportedly led them to the hospital in San Jose.